Maybe you can do a tight tune today, and then I'll be ready to go tomorrow. Or I can try right now.
You want to try?
Let's try. Honestly, my scratchy voice might be cool.
Alright, here we go.
No New Year's Day to celebrate. No chocolate covered candy hearts to give away. No first to spring, no song to sing. In fact, it's just another ordinary
day. You love that? Yeah, that's great. A couple more like that.
Which part is it? The
La Lucha Quiero Night.
I pray you will find your
life.
So why don't we have Mitch do the Italian with me, and then Kirstie comes in on the bridge as her entrance, and she goes all the way to the end. And yeah. Then when I come in, Mitch is starting to belt the thing, because all those big drums come in. And then Kirstie comes in with me on the bridge.
Uh-huh.
And then Mitch, the bridge. Uh-huh. And then Mitch does a, we ask that life be kind. And then Kirstie echoes him, and that's when she's like screaming.
And every heart that's broken will be
mended.
And every heart that's broken will be mended. And we'll remember we are all God's children.
These R's are too open.
Okay.
Like this one is so perfect with
cool.
Scott.
We are
so this is the solo that I didn't know that I've been screaming.
Oh, wait, what about the first part? Did you do that too?
No, Mitch is doing
that. Oh, okay, gotcha.
Yeah.
I could hear like a little sleigh bell that goes throughout.
Yeah,
but I don't want beatboxing.
No.
Yeah, okay.
They just snaps and sleigh bells.
Yeah, agreed.
Probably as far as I can get. Okay, got it.
Or should we actually just do the chords at B?
Probably. Yeah, can we start at B?
So let's just do, let's do without the solos, starting at B.
Okay.
So ready, first chord of B.
Ooh.
Second chord. Right at C. Two, three.
Yeah,
pretty.
Yeah,
kind of agree with you, Mitch.
So I'm the one, I'm the only one that's doing movement there, so maybe I can lead it.
Sure.
You guys can listen to me.
Okay.
You'll never know how many dreams I dreamed about you.
Ooh. Great. Come on in.
It's been a long
That's great. Right there, that's it. That's the song.
That's good to the
last one. It's so good, oh my god.
This even makes me cold because
really
I can tell so much.
Wow.
That is so good.
How exciting. That got me pumped as hell.
No.
Wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
And I do feel like maybe a little bit of party track also might be like nice.
I agree. I think it should have like room noise.
Yeah, exactly. Like,
Party track on it or?
Yeah. What kind of party?
I think low key.
Yeah, low key. Hey, how you feeling?
I just wanted to like.
A sophisticated party.
Over the party track?
So they can't hear like the stage.
Exactly what we're saying.
I want it to be like so muffled.
The ending overs. Is that you as a thing?
I don't know. Why don't we do one where we do all unison four and then he can stack those four and put them copy paste? And then we'll do one where we're in three part for one take.
Oh,
Okay, don't do like a throwaway kind of like. Yeah.
I'll do more breath. something up, but it's too full, but I'll just put breath on the end.
Okay, I think cool. You and I should switch, maybe.
Okay.
Because that would be easier for me to flip.
The river we go. Okay, cool. One, two.
The river we go.
Those last two are really good.
Yeah, the one over the river and through the woods, yeah.
That little dissonant chord in the middle, I kind of like.
Matt and I were wondering, instead of woods, yeah, like woods, just like continue the woods.
I kind of thought that too.
Yeah, something like that.
Oh,
just,
that's nice.
Yeah, the yeah's a little like not in the character of this
like
song.
A flip. It was like.
Through the woods.
I don't think
the
flip is weird, just flipping.
Through the woods.
Yeah.
Wow, that's nice.
Over the river through the woods.
That's fire.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah,
that's killer.
Yeah.
One, two.
Over the river and through the woods.
Yeah, that's good.
Do you okay. Like it kind of like breathy in the beginning and then getting fuller?
Over the river and through the woods.
Let's also try
full voice. That was a good one.
I like that. Do you want to try it full voice right now? Just see what it sounds like. One, two, three.
Over the river and through the woods.
That's kind of sick.
Wait, are you saying you don't like that little crescendo at the beginning?
Oh, I did like it, but I feel like maybe the full voice would be better.
Okay, cool. Oh, I don't.
Over the river and through the woods.
Yeah.
That is fire.
Yeah.
Over the river and through the woods.
Can we do one more that is like that breathier, quieter one just to have, just in case?
Sure.
That sounds better.
Over the river and through the woods.
I like that one.
Over the river through the woods.
Yeah.
Sing.
Yeah.
Sing.
Over the river through the woods.
Sing.
That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the one.
That's a cool section.
Sing.
And it can be really fun with the next two. I like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then the next one is we all start.
We all.
And maybe breath here.
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Y'all are singing, bro.
And all the bells on earth shall ring on Christmas Day, on Christmas Day. And all the bells on earth shall ring on Christmas Day in the morning. Then let us all rejoice again on Christmas Day in the morning.
Morning. A little longer on name.
Pray with us, sail those ships all three on Christmas Day, sheesh, that's so hard.
I think Earth should be Nerth.
On Earth! Okay, yeah.
To begin with.
Yeah.
I'm supposed to have blah, blah,
blah. Nerth.
How are the souls on Nerth?
Then all the souls on earth shall sing on Christmas Day, then all the...
Love it.
That was a good one.
Yeah.
Then let us all rejoice again on Christmas Day, then let us all rejoice again on Christmas Day in the morning.
I mean, just in the game with like body commitment.
That's actually a really nice layer. That sounds great. Cool. Can we record that? That's good. We have enough of those now. That sounds... I love that layer. This is where we get the intricate stuff. Well, I feel like we should get two people going. So it has two different like layers of that. So you and I can probably get... But I feel like there's a... Could be like...
Yeah,
yes,
that's
for sure.
That's
yeah.
Sounds so like, I don't know.
Yeah. Do that. One, two, and. That's gonna be dope.
My snaps are like GF. Do you want them to be like? Like, I was like, GF, and like, you want them to be like.
That's hilarious. Oh,
that's cool.
Oh, that's kind of cool. Oh, yeah, wait. Like, that's kind of cool.
Yeah.
do that, and then you two do. Yeah, let's do that, because I'm kind of doing that too.
Okay.
Like just that, like
that knuckle into that is so nice. Like that rhythm.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, yeah, I like that. That's so cool. Dope.
And it feels like we're on an enemy pirate
ship. Exactly.
We can all do it a little differently. I think it'd be cool. I'm just gonna.
Which mic should we use?
I'm yeah.
Okay, Kirstie.
<Garcia. laughs> 1, 2, 3, and.
Let's go!
That's pretty yeah, dope. That's stacked.
Actually, do it with him.
Okay.
And you and I go. So it'd be like 1, 2, 3, and.
I think that's gonna be cool.
Right, yeah, I get it. That's
wait, can we just hear all that, what we just did, and like everything together?
This is gonna be dope. What are you doing over this as beatboxing wise?
I don't know if I was doing anything.
Oh, you weren't?
I think he said he wanted it to be like more body percussion, and then like it just kind of grew. The only time I started doing beatboxing he wanted was wherever that part.
Peace out, dude. See you later.
The moon is red, the spirit's up, we're here tonight, and that's enough.
I cannot remember elbows up and head on the choir, and Matt, you have a little extra hop in your step on this, and everybody else is kind of just
chilling. Oh, good time in your shine.
Yes. I love it.
Thank
though.
You.
I
no,
love it.
Enthusiasm.
Okay.
Chill out.
Great.
Days you can't bum.
Yeah.
Oh, you're
third?
Third. Oh, I don't think you were yesterday.
Right? Mitchie?
Yeah, third.
Me. 1, 2, 4, 6. Yeah, that's us.
I would bet $100.
I'll bet $100. I definitely was third.
Like this.
Yes.
You're second.
Cool.
$100 for.
Give me the $100.
Damn it. I was so positive. That wasn't real bad. We were joking.
Totally. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You're giving her 100? Okay, fine. Now I have to.
Can I get it to be? Alright, so we'll teach this part first. Last section. There it goes. 1, 2. 1, 2. And it's gotta go.
All right, Team Scott, what's up? Okay, so we have an easy part. It's just two snaps. Snap, snap.
Thanks. All right, so this is my part. Come on. You definitely have the hardest part.
Someone open the door!
Thank you. So this one's kind of hard. So it goes 1, 1, 1, 1, 1.
And if all that's really hard for you, you can follow me.
By default.
I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day, on Christmas Day. I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day in the morning.
But we're in the valley today and we're rehearsing for a Christmas tour. And it's going well. I'm forgetting every step, every move.
Grown a little bolder, grown a little sadder, grown a little more of a little angel, city on my shoulder.
Oh,
it's been a long time since I took a neighborly slice of fruitcake.
Everybody goes forward.
Luckily, we have our amazing choreographers, Lindsay Blaufarb and Craig Holloman, and I think it's gonna be great. I mean, I'm excited for my favorite things because I think it's the most theatrical, but it's absolutely not in my body whatsoever, so once that happens, then I think it'll be great.
Wait, pause. What do we do, the thingy?
No.
Oh yeah,
that's
new.
This is our 50th Christmas.
Does my true love give to me? 5 golden rings, 4 calling birds,
3 French hens,
2 turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
Okay, so we just wrapped rehearsals here. We put a whole show together in 3 days. It was mayhem. This is probably my favorite Christmas tour we've ever done because we do so many songs that I love, and it's our longest set list. There might be, I might be playing piano in it. We'll see. But we feel ready, we're excited. We have a few days off and tech rehearsals, and then the first show in Baltimore.
You ready?
Ready to see it?
Yeah, actually I'm ready to see it. I'm excited to see it.
Oh my gosh!
Wow! Oh my gosh, wait, the cake looks amazing!
I am quite literally speechless. Wow. Wow.
In times when we don't know.
We have a couple options. You just want to thumb through them all?
Yeah.
Let's just start panning through the options here.
Oh, that's cool.
And you know, obviously, guys, we can light the drape to whatever color works with the video. Nice. I think.
Yeah. I feel like the red for the beginning of the show just feels like really classic.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it kind of goes with the whole like show vibe of the curtain lifting up and all.
No, but I didn't know if she was telling. Oh,
the audience. Stage, right? Whoa.
I thought we were on.
I didn't see you there.
So we are in our rehearsals in Lititz, Pennsylvania. Today is the second day, our final day, before we go to Baltimore, Thanksgiving break, and then Baltimore. And everything, we just our first run through, and stumbled through some things, but things actually like really came together, so we're really excited. The show feels really, really amazing, and the set's amazing. I can't wait for everyone to see it, and it's just nice to be on stage again.
Pop pop it up, do pop it up, pop, scoopy the pop pop, scoppy doopy dab, shoop cop, jazz. It don't mean a thing if you ain't got that thing. Do a what, do a, do a, do a, do a, do a, do a, do a. This is our dress rehearsal, our last run through the show before the actual show. And not in the front, we look. Amazing.
Kristen's walking.
Welcome to Lititz, Pennsylvania, and have yourselves a fantastic rehearsal.
Kiss me twice, then kiss me once again. It's been a long, long
sound check. I have missed going to makeup, like all of the things I missed while touring is happening today, and I'm overstimulated. I feel like I need to constantly keep myself calm or else I'm gonna just burst out in excitement.
It feels good. It feels good to be kind of active and working and just kind of moving my body, moving around, feeling the spirit, warming my voice up, kind of dreading another day off, to be honest, alone with my thoughts. But here I can be anything I want.
And what are you right now?
Sort of festive. Right now I am peace, I am whole.
I just have to say, this show is really special.
Yay!
And it comes from you guys. And it's gorgeous, it's beautiful, it's stunning, you guys sound amazing, and I just want to say how grateful we are to still be a part of your team, and it's always an honor. And it's going to be so special for all the families. I mean, they haven't seen a show in how long, and
probably
been able to be together, and you know, I feel like this show specifically is going to be really healing for a lot of people.
Live y'all's best life the whole show. It's great. We love y'all. We're so proud of y'all. Thank you. And let's just give them what they came here for, which is to just feel everything and feel just as magical as y'all. So.
Love you. Thank you.
Little nugget. You know that? You're a little nugget.
Nugget.
I miss my pup. But oh, thank you. But,
you are listening to the takeover.
I am so unbelievably excited for this tour. It's a little different though. We just did our VIP and it was so fun, but still everybody had to be masked. We had to keep a little bit of distance from them. So it's different, but it's still super fun.
All right, we're gonna do a little Q&A. So if any of you have any questions,
if you were a pasta noodle, what shape would you be?
I would be an uncooked spaghetti.
I would be...
It was actually really amazing. It got me really excited for the show tonight. And I'm just excited to see what everyone thinks of the show, because I'm very excited about it, so I hope you guys like it. And if you don't...
If you don't, here's a clue.
I'm not even nervous tonight, because I have wanted to do this for now a year and a half, and it's been so weird to not see a fan. It's so weird not to have their embrace. It's so weird not to be able to sign autographs in front of them. But I still hope that tonight they feel our love, and I know we're gonna feel theirs too. So I'm actually like really excited for that. Like I have not a nerve in my body because of it. Like, I just want to serve and perform, so.
I mean, I'm sure it's pretty weird. You were doing this for 10 years for like 9 months of the year.
Legit. And then it all stops. Like, what in the world?
Yeah,
Is it weird to say, like, I kind of need this. Like, I'm being serious. Like, I feel like I kind of need the adrenaline rush because, I mean, having a baby is one thing. That's one type of adrenaline rush, but like, still nothing compares to the feeling that you have on stage. And I feel like having both, being a parent and that, kind of comes together in this like balanced adrenaline rush that I need.
Oh, shoot, that's crazy.
Yeah.
I'm ready.
Yeah, no, it feels like it's been forever.
Yeah.
But also when I was getting ready, I was like, oh, we're back.
Exactly. He's like, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's like, been a long time. One, two. On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a partridge in a pear tree. Okay, so we're practicing 12 days of Christmas because it is one of our hardest arrangements because it's chaotic and completely random, and we've never performed it before because it's from We Need a Little Christmas, the album from last year during the pandemic. So it's new to us, it's chaotic, and it's the finale of our show. So we've got some work to do. From your places.
Sorry.
It's also down in the stuff.
Oh.
Oh, the not, yeah, after nine is your other or whatever.
Yeah. Oh, wait, no. After nine, you do it by yourself.
Wait.
After eight is the harmonized.
Six is a lame by golden rings. Four golden birds, three French and two turtle doves. And a partridge in a pear.
The
moon is right. The spirits of we're here tonight. The party's on.
We're gonna try at the top of the show saying, on your feet! So people stand up and it gives them permission to have fun and dance.
Christmas time.
another show. We about to do it. This time each year.
And the real famous cat all dressed up in red. And he spends the whole year working out on his sled.
I'm late.
For what?
For soundtrack. And I gotta grab my mask. I need a snack though. It's really fast. I don't know where I am.
Hello.
Hi. We're going to hold an additional 15 and go at 7:45.
Coolio. What % sold already, do you know?
The floor and the lower bowl are pretty much sold out.
Okay. Cool. Thank you.
It's been, you've done two shows. You guys got kind of the kinks out. You got the flow of it down a little bit. Like, what's like kind of your favorite moment of the show? What do you think?
Probably one of my favorite moments of the show would be when Kevin and I get to do our like drum thing. Like, it's so epic because when we built it out and we rehearsed it and practiced it, it was all improvised. And to see the reaction we get from when people, after we do that, and it's like, it's like the loudest roar ever.
I really like, when we return from the intermission with the star drop background, and it looks like we're in outer space and we're singing Hallelujah. I always think that's a really powerful moment. I don't know why, but I always love performing The Grinch. Something about the choreo is it's just big enough to where I'm not exhausting myself doing it, but I still enjoy it and I feel like Liza Minnelli.
So this is one of the hardest parts of putting a look together. Now it takes a lot of concentration because the lines have to be very clean and straight. Now the iMac cameras, they get very close-up shots, and so every little error can be seen. Now look at this. No errors.
Beautiful. I love in the second act, we go to the front of the stage and sing I Just Called to Say I Love You in Evergreen, and it just feels like a really special moment, and it just, the acoustics sound really nice, and it feels a little more intimate because we're closer to the audience, and it's just nice.
I'm probably gonna say Evergreen. Now that I am a parent and I watch my wife mother this child from sleepless nights to diaper changes to feeding, so she's such a dedicated mother, and now I think back to what my parents did and I am so unbelievably grateful. And so to be able to relay that to every single person on stage now is amazing, because people are here with their families, and I'm sure there's a lot of people out there who feel the same way about their moms.
There must have been some magic in that old silk hat they found.
Definitely my favorite part is Thank You, because the song is so special to me, and it's like, it feels so impactful and emotional. I think we all have those people in our lives that are really special to us, especially during the pandemic when we needed love the most. And so I think everyone in the crowd is thinking about that person for them, and obviously I'm thinking about Mark, so it's an emotional moment. And I also feel like since I co-wrote these words with Mark, when I'm playing and singing, I feel like such an artist, like I'm actually storytelling and connecting with people in that way, which is really fun to do. Sweeter than a choir. To choose, so all I can say is thank you. Mm-hmm.
I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day, on Christmas Day. I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day in the morning.
So crazy. It's been almost 2 years since we have done a live show. You guys have no idea how good it feels.
The energy in this room is really good. Do you guys feel it?
La da 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 da. It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their hearts of gold.
I'm not crazy, right?
Yeah, you signed this one, Twitch.
I saw curses in it.
You trying to, you don't want me to sign it or something?
Nah, dog, I just... You know what? How do we make this special for somebody?
Just a tongue.
The lip ring. Double sign.
Matt double sign.
That's what I get for making fun of you.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Happy holidays.
back at Mohegan Sun, because one, this is such an iconic arena, that's such a dream to play, and also we've been back so many times that like it's cool to see us having signed the wall 6 years ago and all the memories we have here. Also, last time we were here, they inducted us into the Hall of Fame, which was such an honor. The whole day has felt really special because we're like seeing people again, we're playing this iconic arena that we have memories at, and then also I just like feel like the show is going to be one for the books, because so many people are coming, and based on the energy we got from VIP, I feel like that's gonna translate to the show. I'm just pumped.
We should play up there when you walk around.
I'll just walk up to there then?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're not really that close. You're gonna be over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had a different sound check today. This is the first time that we're doing our show without a thrust, which sucks, obviously, because we want to have the full shebang. So we had to re-choreograph some things, restage some things.
Should we just stay?
I think we
should go out.
Oh, wow.
Yes, for now.
But not as daunting or stressful as I thought it was gonna be. So hopefully nobody in Verona, New York is disappointed. Yeah, the only thing is, I mean, I don't get to run out onto the stage with my little garland around my neck like a queen, a prancing queen. Great song.
Go for it. Go for it. Why not? Solid. Solid drive.
Knock knock. Scotty. I have a TikTok idea.
What?
Because I have a theory. I watched Free Guy the other day with Ryan Reynolds, and I have this theory that Ryan Reynolds loves pentatonics.
Stop. Wait. It's crazy that you're saying this because I've thought that before.
Have you seen Free Guy?
I've seen Free Guy.
Okay. There's a line in it where he says, blah, blah, my taste in blue shirts, and then my taste in five octave musical superstars.
Us?
And we've already talked about how in Deadpool that he says our names.
Yeah, yeah, I remember Deadpool 1, he says like, Kevin, Scott, Mitch, and I was like, that's
hello?
That's too much of a coincidence.
Yeah. And he also did your TikTok thing too, where he like...
Oh yeah, the Igamiba, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So.
Wow.
So I'm just trying to get him to see us,
I can't wait to sing with him after he sees this.
I know.
I can't tell if this is a stretch or if this is like dead on.
It's too close. It's too real.
Okay, let's make it.
Let's do it.
Hey, is AJ's your actual name? Because it sounds suspiciously made up. What is it really? Kevin? Scott? Mitch?
Kristen? Kristen Scott and Mitch?
Hi, Kristen. You're my Kristen Dunst. Kristen? Your taste. Shirts.
Okay.
It's real.
It may be a stretch. Maybe we're just like delusional fans of Ryan Reynolds, but I really think that's a lot of coincidences.
Thanks, Ryan.
Yeah, Ryan, if you see this, just let us know if you're a Pentatonics fan.
Yes.
And if you're not, lie to us.
Yes, please.
Please.
Please lie to us.
Please.
Very excited. All the shows have been so great. It's just nice to be back out there. Happy to be in New York. And I'm happy to have a little. We need a little Christmas night. We need a little Christmas night. We need a little Christmas night. Hey!
Da 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 da. The snowman was a jolly happy soul with the corn cob pipe and a
so we power walked many blocks for these bagels because they're the best bagels in New York and also the best bagels are in New York. And look at that. Yeah. None for little.
One day there must have been some magic in that old silk hat they found. For when they placed it on his head, he began to dance around. Oh, Frosty the snowman was alive as he could be. And the children say he can laugh and play just the same as he.
So most of you think that basketball is my favorite sport. Cue the clip. Let's go, I quit. But actually, my true love is hockey. And tonight, we're playing a show at the New Jersey Devils Arena in New Jersey. This is Captain's Hall, the classics. Wow, Scott Stevens, Mel, Andy, Matt.
This is the weighted rod. Now, some people may think that this is just, you know, for strength and conditioning, but it's actually dance.
And I was just teaching the world this. So it's here. So hold, squat, hit, hold, go! That's hockey.
Come on, two more,
It's kind of like a growl.
All right, I'm gonna go to dinner. Because you know what else you need in hockey? Sustenance.
Yes. I am feeling really good about the show tonight. First thing is, it's nice that the show is in our bodies now, and I don't have any fear going on stage because I know the show so well, and I think we all feel that way. Also, there's so many people coming to the show tonight, which is so exciting because we're doing it in a professional hockey arena. I mean, I'm not even a hockey person, but I see the Stanley Cup banners all over the place, and there's so much history with the team. And so, I don't know, it's cool to know that we've made it this far into this place, into this space. It should be a really good night. We've always had the cello moment because it's a part of our story. The way the band found me was I had a song playing cello beatbox.
Kevin playing cello was such an integral part of how we found him and how we formed his Pentatonics because he had that viral cello boxing video. But
something about this tour that's different is we're playing instruments. We have cello, guitar, piano, and drums at one point. And I feel like that's something we've always been scared of because
we were just so, the integrity of the group was a cappella, but now I think it's shifted a little bit. I think what's so beautiful about us is that we're just embracing the inner artist in each of us. And
it's cool because every single person has different talents that sometimes aren't necessarily shown.
Drums have always been a part of, you know, my life. And over the pandemic, I bought a drum set and I've really grown a newfound love for the drums. And so to be able to incorporate the drum on this tour has been like amazing. I feel like every night I get lost in it and I just go look at it. I just start looking around and I'm like, wait, it's like an outer body experience. So.
You know, my original dream as a kid was to be a piano playing singer songwriter. And that's what I went to college for. That was always the goal. So now being up there playing piano and singing Thank You, which I co-wrote, it just feels like all my 8-year-old Scott dreams are coming true. And it's a kind of an emotional experience each night.
It's so crazy to me that I'm using these two pieces of who I am on stage as my main career, and it's fun. It's challenging, it's hard, and I have a blast kind of learning more about myself through these instruments.
I think the important thing about the instruments is that they're never gonna take away from the voices because that, you know, that's the ethos of the group. But it definitely is fun to have new sounds.
It's something new and it keeps things exciting, especially after 10 years.
To be an artist means that you need to expand and you need to elevate and you need to experiment. And
you know, after the pandemic, we're coming back strong with some new sounds and showing some other sides to us. And it's been going over really well, which is great because I've had this fear that after I was done with Thank You playing piano, that people were gonna think like, oh, that's why they're a cappella. So, but no one thought that. Everyone loves it. And so it's been really fun, a fun new endeavor for us.
And I don't have to play a single one. I always tell Scott every time he goes up to play the piano, I'm like, thank God this isn't me, because I would be a wreck. So you're strong.
I like it. We have like a whole little section that has the instruments in it, so hopefully you're not mad at it.
Now we're back in my element. This is what I've missed. Basketball is truly my favorite sport. And I got the court to myself. Let's go. This is what they call Steph Curry rings. Cue the clip.
Curry way downtown. Bang!
This is my first mixtape for the Celebrity All-Star Game. Play no games.
Say it. Ow. Is that whistle?
Yeah.
I didn't even know you could start to even like.
On our way. Very excited.
Yes.
Love. This is my favorite part. It's what I've missed the most.
Yes, man.
Touring. Being able to meet the fans.
Right
here. Hello. And
exactly.
Hometown show. Louisville.
Hometown
Kentucky.
Show. How
exactly.
You feel, bro?
I feel good. And I want to make sure it's Louisville.
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 I'll make sure. You said it right.
I'll make sure I say it
yes,
right.
Yes. No, exactly.
I practice.
Because if anybody say Louisville, I'm coming for them.
Louisville.
Y'all, I am so happy to be back home. I am from Kentucky. So it is so good to be back in my home state, y'all. It is so good to be back.
I think the show's gonna be really fun. There's so many amazing fans out there. And it's my home state show. You know, I grew up in Kentucky. I think that's also why I have a little bit of a heavy heart at the same time, because of the tornado that went through. I mean, Mayfield, Bowling Green, that's literally my backyard where I grew up in Owensboro. So it's a little weird to perform at the same time, but I am excited for the show. So, you know, we're gonna address it, we're gonna say something, because it doesn't feel right to not address it. But at the end of the day, I do hope that tonight people still get a great show and that they still get the best of us.
Now, before we do this next song, we wanted to actually take a second to address the tornado that came through Kentucky yesterday night. It was horrific, it was tragic, and we wanted to have a little bit of a moment of silence for all those who are affected. It's just a moment of silence.
Thank you guys so much. We'd also like to dedicate this next song to everyone affected, and I hope you guys enjoy the song. It's called Amazing Grace.
Unending love, amazing grace. I once was lost, but now I'm found.
Bring us in, Matt. Dum, 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 dum. All right, Mitch. Dum, 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 dum. Come on, Kevin. Dum, dum, dum. Hey.
Oh, there's no place like home.
Hi. I love that he's excited to see me.
Past the halfway mark, how you feeling?
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's right. Whoa. I feel actually really energetic. I mean, I did just have an espresso, but I feel great.
Try it again. We were torn.
Okay. Thanks. No bangs.
I think I prefer this, but they don't look like
I was
bad.
Thinking bangs with the other outfit, but I feel like this has like a full
yeah.
look with it too.
Came together. here in the final hour.
That's good.
Where's our rhythm section?
I met a man who lives in Tennessee. And he was headed for
Pennsylvania. Oh, hey.
There's the rhythm section. We've been looking all over. I turn my back and find myself out on the.
Sorry. I was ready to go with the musical.
It's from Dream Girl.
I like your choice of a singing style.
Sunny shore, from Atlantic to Pacific. Gee, the traffic is terrific. Oh, there's no place like home.
Another day in Rosemont, Illinois, everybody.
It is a windy city,
everybody,
isn't
on?
It?
Yeah, let's hit it.
To you and your kin, good tidings for Christmas and a happy new year.
Whoa, why are you so cool?
Even grapes?
Oh, seriously?
Is it Kyle?
I think it's
Kyle. I got the fish too.
You got the fish? Oh, we fish, brother.
I got transparent.
Oh, I like yours.
Thank you.
We traded.
We did.
I always get like transparent.
Oh, that's what
and clear,
I had before.
But I was like, I'm going to do black. Like a starry night.
Look at this. So cool.
Good tidings for Christmas. Good tidings for Christmas. Good tidings for Christmas. And a happy new year.
Oh. I think you may like pull the string.
I just ripped my shoelace 10 minutes before show. So I'm either gonna have to make it work or I have these other shoes that I like too. I'm just gonna wear the other ones so I don't have to think about this right now.
Notice a lot of You guys are really happy on stage. There's a lot of laughter. You guys feel more yourselves maybe than ever on stage. Why do you feel that is?
I think Pentatonix is so excited to be back on the road and touring and connecting with fans that we just have so much energy. We're so energized by this process. And we like to banter on stage and connect with fans because I think that's what everyone wants most right now. We were all isolated for so long. So now we just want to laugh and we want to be real. We want to be vulnerable. We want to be honest.
And this was a long time ago. We were reminiscing recently about how long ago this was. 14 years or something?
Half our lives ago.
Don't look too close.
That's a crazy way to put it.
Yeah, isn't it?
Yeah, high school is wild. That was my, you know, pretending to be straight era. My dad's like, I know if you work hard, you'll be a professional basketball player. I was like, yes.
It's been 2 years since we've been on stage together and been able to perform and tour, and so we obviously missed it. We missed all the fans, we missed all the interactions, but I think the best part about, and what's special about this specific tour, is that we missed each other. And you can tell, because when somebody's talking, we're always laughing, engaging, or saying little side comments.
Well, I have a little bit of a bone to pick with the band. Also, I love you too, by the way. A little bit of a bone. Because they told me to introduce the song, and I'm like, this feels a little bit on the nose for me. Little drummer boy.
it's really like this beautiful, genuine like family. Oh man, I love what I get to do, and I've missed being able to do it with my other bandmates, and it's really special.
Good tidings for Christmas.
Good tidings for Christmas.
Good tidings for Christmas and a happy
We are in Grand Rapids, Michigan today, and we only have 5 shows left, which is so wild because that's always like the thing for tour. Like, you're in the beginning and you're like, oh my gosh, wow, I'm so excited to be out and how many shows we have, yay, yay, yay. And then somewhere in the middle, you hit like your stride, and then all of a sudden it zooms by. And just all the shows have been so amazing and so great, and it's been so nice to be back on stage.
This has been probably my favorite tour, I think, that we've ever done. It was great to kind of take a back seat for a second. I guess we couldn't help it because of COVID, but you know, that really sort of, I realized what my priorities are, and performing and spreading joy is definitely up there, if not the top.
I just missed performing, and we used to do this all the time, and it was such a part of our lives, and then it was completely gone for 2 years, and there's just such a joy that I know we all 5 of us have about live performing and being in front of the audience and the exchange of energy. And so it's just been amazing.
I think the band has never been closer, and I really missed the, you know, the reciprocity of the audience versus the performer. There is just nothing like that feeling, and I'm so glad that we've sort of reignited that flame.
But this whole month has been just so incredible. The fans, the stories that we've heard from fans. I mean, there was a fan who was a physician, and she talked about how this has been a really difficult year for her. And
I want you to know that this is my therapeutic cancer. And it's been a rough time, and it's been your music. You don't know us on a sea of strange dreams, but just we know you know it's got the one and one. Anyway, music has kept us going, no matter how you really know that.
She was crying as she was talking about. So just fan stories like that that make you realize that it's just, it's all worth it.
All right, 10,000 people out there, and I am pretending I'm not nervous because, as Rihanna says, pretend, fake it till you make it. Because the other option is
cry myself to sleep. Who wants to do that?
I love needing your calcium bars. Nothing fits me anymore.
Oh man, my coach used to make me eat like those like great game. Yeah, 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 yeah. That's I've seen Mean Girls a lot. So.
Directly quote from the movie. Yeah,
directly quote from the movie. We have to talk on stage in a minute. Come on in. So today we are in Minneapolis. We are at the Target Center. It's this epic, epic arena. And you know, our last show was our biggest Christmas show ever, but we already beat that record. Tonight, there's like over 11,000 people coming, I think. And it's just so surreal to think that even after the pandemic and not touring for 2 years, that this many people are down to come support. Just exactly at
12 o'clock. Biggest Christmas show ever. 11,000 people. Pretty wild. Turn up for Christmas, Minneapolis.
Hey. I feel like Vanna. This is what I see every time I come into my room.
It's also wild that we can even put this show together and all the people that it takes to put the show together. Everyone works so hard and it's all so exciting, and I'm just like feeling really grateful.
That's how we feel in Minneapolis. Merry Christmas! After 2 years, and guess what? Our last show was our biggest Christmas show ever, but we already broke that record tonight.
There's more room so we can travel
for that ending
part.
Yeah, okay, I'll just say it like this one.
Yeah.
Okay,
and then
seven. Bow, bow,
bow,
bow, bow, seven,
six, he's like,
five, gold, and
he's four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight, nine, ten.
Did we spread out there?
I think we did.
Oh, yeah.
We went this way.
Two,
we had 5.5.
Can I just be right here again?
Yes, and I'll just go right here. Face it,
I'll face down.
Are we going? Oh, 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 oh.
I'm gonna ride it. Oh, ride it. Yeah.
Woo! Floop! Yeah, I wish that Floop was my dog, but he ain't. I ain't got him. Now it's Kirsty. Oh, it's Ben.
Hey!
Oh, I wish I had one.
Hey.
Oh, no, I'm playing. Oh, I don't want no dog. She does. She does. Okay, let's get a dog. No!
Three shows left. This is the third to last show that we're about to do in like half an hour. Somebody at VIP actually was like, what song do you feel brings you peace out of your repertoire? And I said, Evergreen. It's been Evergreen for me, especially on this tour. Just every time we sing it, I just feel it so much. And it's such a beautiful song. It's therapeutic for me to sing to because it's so pleasing to my ear. You know, the lyrics really resonate with me so much. They make me emotional and they make me feel a lot of gratitude for my mother and how much of a warrior she was growing up.
It's about the love that mothers have and how they make everything so special. But Evergreen has been more than just the song within this year, because it's been so special to come together after such a long year of being apart and record this album. It was one of the first times that we were all able to come in the studio together and really collaborate and sing each song with each other. And
coming out of the pandemic, we hadn't sung together in a long time. We got together in the studio, we sang and we brainstormed and we made music and magic together, and it was such a beautiful, beautiful thing.
Normally, you know, we, especially in the last year within the pandemic, we go in and we do everything separately so it's like perfect and spot on, but there's something so magical about doing it in the studio and having that live, organic vibe about it. It's just, it's that live, beautiful quality that you want to see at shows. And then doing Evergreen the tour has been so amazing. It's been my favorite tour to date.
And to work so hard and to have this amazing crew that's worked so hard and to thankfully get no COVID cases and be able to do the whole tour.
Now I'm just kind of thinking about all the things that I'm grateful for on this tour and how I'm grateful for the band for just being so amazing and working so hard.
For the people that we work with on our crew who've sacrificed their time with their families, who have risked their safety.
Especially in a time like this where, you know, we don't know if we're going to get COVID on the road. And that's a real serious thing that we have to think about. So we thank them for what they've done. You know, we're also trying to do the same where
we've all been really quarantined on this tour, staying inside our rooms, staying inside hotels, not going out to dinners, not really seeing anybody. For them to be able to sacrifice what they have, we're just eternally grateful, you know. And
you hear all about all the shows on Broadway and all these other tours and things that people are getting COVID, and we're almost there, we're almost to the end, and we haven't done that, and it takes a lot of sacrifice and a lot of love and a lot of work from all our crew and all our people.
But the fact that we've been able to do this and for fans to actually come, like, none of y'all had to come to this tour. Obviously, it's a time where, you know, we want to think about everybody's safety, but the fact that you all would come and still support what we're doing, it just makes us want to give so much more to you all when we go on stage.
It's just been really amazing, and it's been so fun, and it's been our biggest Christmas tour ever, and that's been rocking, because 11,000 people at a Christmas show, I mean, turn up Christmas. I love that.
I'm so grateful and so overwhelmed at how incredible this whole album era has been. And it's just, the word evergreen is such a perfect term for it, because evergreen means forever, you know? And that's what it feels like Pentatonix is something that's lasting forever, because after 10 years, I do think we're stronger, closer, and happier than we've ever been. Oh, mother's love is evergreen.
Sasha Fluvian, me and you both, buddy.
Tired.
We both yawn. And yawn. Oh, I thought he was about to do it. That would be crazy.
Oh Lord, it's been a year with little joys and little fears. It's finally here, Christmas Day. My love, I need some hope. A little faith.
Wait, what just happened? What did I do?
Oh my gosh, look at this lovely. Look at this.
Oh, you won!
I won!
Oh, yay!
Yeah,
you won! Yo, kill it!
I love family support.
Oh, let's go!
I know.
Protein, vegetable, a little bit of carbs, healthy carbs. Gotta stay fit for the wedding. Gotta get fit for the wedding. Gotta fit into a tux for a wedding.
We're in Grand Prairie. It's our second to last show. I'm going to see my pups. I haven't seen them since they went on tour. I'm very excited.
Hello! 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 Hello!
Hello! Hello! This is a first. Mitch is the only one that out.
Oh my gosh.
Never.
Hold the show for Mitch.
Very
yeah.
She always runs away from the camera. Hides behind the case again. They told us that the mayor is gonna make December 22nd Pentatonix Day in Grand Prairie, Texas, which is so exciting.
Hey, Grand Prairie, this is Mayor Ron Jensen. Welcome you to the show tonight. Let's have a great time tonight. Y'all know it. Pentatonix is from right next door in Arlington. Went to Arlington Martin. Going forward, December 22nd will be Pentatonix Day. Pentatonix Day in Grand Prairie. Thank y'all. Let's have a great show.
That's so awesome. And what an honor. And now we're about to give them the best show ever. Let's do it.
Spent all this time hanging lights, but I'm just blinded by your eyes. I look outside, the ground is white, but you.
Are you nervous?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you sounded great. I think you're gonna be great.
We had this spontaneous idea. My dad plays guitar, and so I'm gonna call him up on stage, and he's gonna play Evergreen with us. And he's never done anything like this before, so he's very nervous, but I'm so excited. It's gonna be such a special memory for my family and for the band. And my mom is gonna be a wreck. And if I can make it through the song without crying, then we have succeeded.
Yeah, that was much better. That was good.
Yeah,
that's enough.
Yeah,
that was much better.
Yeah,
thank you.
Does everything sound good?
I start concentrating on the click and then I forget the chords.
Following voices is so what I'm used to doing.
Yeah, that was easier for me.
Yeah. Totally. It also sounded rootsy and aggressive.
Yeah, one of the reasons why I learned English, I'm not from the United States, I'm from the Dominican Republic. Would you like to hear me sing my favorite Evergreen song?
Job, we need a sixth member.
Excuse me, can I say the hallelujah?
Of course. Go ahead. You started off.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
Oh my god. You sound like I'm gonna sound up for tomorrow.
Oh my gosh.
That's my favorite song. I love you, and I also like Ariana.
Oh my god! You have a great taste in music.
Sometimes, Pascal, when I do lip trills, specifically warming up, I've been doing them in the house. It first started when I was in New York and I was warming up before my shows, and all of a sudden I would just hear, and I would turn around and Pascal would be doing it with me. Very cute. And then one time, all three of them did it all together. It was pretty amazing.
I'm a director now.
Oh gosh, it's a bad idea.
Hey, Ben.
There you go.
It's your birthday, man. Yo, how's your birthday going? Like, how are you feeling? Like, what are you thinking? How's it going?
Yeah, so today is my 30th birthday. We're in Grand Prairie. Yesterday was Pentatonix Day.
So old!
I really felt more mean than anything, actually.
That was good. Head cut. You know, last show.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling exhausted but excited. Simultaneously.
Yes.
Can't believe it.
You know what? It's been a long.
I know. I felt that.
It's okay.
No, it's been a great tour.
It's been an amazing tour. Probably my favorite tour we've ever done.
Definitely.
Yeah, I agree.
Last show. Thank you for coming to see us.
I am just, this is the final show, so I'm kind of in my feelings a little bit, but I just have to say that this has been a beautiful tour experience, and we are just so grateful that we get the opportunity to share this show with you. So thank you.
Such an incredible experience. Thank you for following this journey and supporting everything that has to do with Evergreen. We love you. Have a wonderful Christmas, a wonderful holiday.
Stay safe and healthy. Yeah. Yeah.
We love you.
And we'll see you in 2022, so y'all.
See you in the new year.
She carries, she tired, lose the mood.